Everyone, welcome to Live Darts. We're here at the Unibet Premier League launch and we've got Raymond van Barneveld. Raymond, are you looking forward to this year's Premier League campaign as your last?
Of course, yeah. This is the last week one of the play in the Premier League, and next week is the last week two of the Premier League. I'm really excited. Very happy that the PDC gave me another chance. You know, I'm 28 in the world now, so I was really flabbergasted that I got the wild card. So thanks to Sky and the PDC, so a big thank you. And now it's on me, you know. Hope to do very well in the Premier League, especially them nights in Rotterdam, of course. So I was really looking forward to them.
After the Worlds, did you think maybe the opportunity for the Premier League had gone?
Of course, you're looking at worst case scenario, 28 in the world, you know. I had a couple of options. My head was all bad at the moment in the beginning of January. I'm thinking I quit now, which is not good for the fans, for the sponsors, for the PDC. Option two was, if I got invited, maybe skip the Premier League and do the rest. Option three was, play the Premier League and eventually maybe some World Series and then that's it, which was a good option. But I want to go for the World Championship, you know. I want to aim for that and lift the trophy there at the end. So there was only one option left, and then there was option four, and play as much as I can.
Obviously, with the Premier League, it's one game a week, so you know the set format. Is that easier for yourself, getting yourself up for that game, knowing who it is and what it is?
It is, but if you... It's not only the Premier League, you know. Every Friday we travel to the Pro Tour as well. So sometimes, looking at this week, I'm leaving at Tuesday night, Wednesday press day, Thursday you play the Premier League, Friday you travel to the Pro Tour or Euro Tour, and then you compete in the weekend, you know. So you come back on Monday morning, and Monday morning is week two already. So you're doing this 17 weeks on the spin. The results in the weekend are really important for your next week's Premier League as well. So if you do well on the weekend, then your form is fantastic. You will feel that in your system, that the form is fantastic, and you do well in the Premier League the next match. If you play bad in the Premier League and the weekend, so you really is getting harder to adjust for next week.
As well, the tournament lost Gary Anderson through injury. Yeah. Do you think that's a massive blow to the tournament itself?
Of course, Gary is phenomenal, won the Premier League twice. I feel sorry, you know, really recovering quick. The PDC now got nine youngsters, you know, like contenders. I think they're doing a really good job to give them the opportunity, maybe in the future, younger players to get involved in the Premier League. So I think that's very good. I'm looking at Max Hopp in Berlin for 14,000. Not really happy on that, but Max Hopp or Gary Anderson in Berlin, I think it's a massive difference.
Do you think if you were one of the pros that missed out through, obviously, Gary getting injured, there's a few in and around the top 16 and the top 8, do you think they've got a right to feel aggrieved maybe that they haven't come in to replace Gary?
I don't know, it's not on me, you know. I always find it hard to pick 10 players, you know. Luckily, I'm not me to make that decisions, but I'm pretty sure the PDC had one or two meetings to do what they did now. I think it's okay, but I heard a lot of players and managers and people on Twitter moan about how can you invite nine players and then playing for ranking points, you know. I don't know. I have an opinion, of course, like everybody else, but my opinion, I think, is not really important. I'm just happy to be involved in the Premier League. So what can I say if you're number 28 in the world? You just have to say a big thank you to the PDC and you still be involved at the Sky.
As well, you touched on the nights at Rotterdam. I know you don't want to overlook everyone else, but is that in the back of your mind, that Rotterdam being the pinnacle of those first 9 weeks?
Oh yeah, and the last night against Michael. So again, I think that there's a hard part, you know. It feels a bit like the national team of Holland is playing the national team of Holland. So for a 10,000 crowd, who are you going to support? Well, last year it turns out that maybe out of 10,000, maybe 9,000 supporting Raymond van Barneveld and Barney Army. So I was really pleased on that. But at the end, that's one night. You want to win the Premier League, and Michael did that. So if I can make a decision, rather win the Premier League than just one night in Rotterdam. But don't get me wrong, Rotterdam is far out the best night for me to compete, of course.
As well, looking obviously to the rest of the year, you've touched on the Worlds is your last. Before then, is it important, obviously, for yourself to qualify for the match play, your final match play,
of course,
and things like that as well?
If you compare it to Phil's year, when you say goodbye the world, one more year, you know, he was still top four, top five in the world. So that means he was everywhere. He was in the match play, he was in the World Grand Prix. So to me, it's different. I have to start from scratch again. I have to do well, not really attempting on the pro tour. I have to make really good efforts and get ranking points, you know. I think I need 20,000, 25,000 to be in the top 32 in the world, which gave me getting in the second round, and otherwise I will be in trouble. So the first target is get myself in a world match play, which guaranteed me at least 10k already to build up for the world championship. At the end, you want to be there in the world championship and have a good run over there, of course, and hopefully you win it.
Again, obviously the Euro Tour is going to play a really important part of your season, because the money on the Euro Tour now is absolutely phenomenal. Is it key to qualify for all them as well, for your season as well?
I reject against six or seven exhibitions to try to qualify. What you're gonna do? But then you don't know if you perform well on the day. So I practice really hard at the moment. The Premier League is one thing to look, you know, but my biggest aim is get myself in the World Championship. So I need all the ranking base tournaments to do well, perform well in them.
In your final year, do you still believe there is a big title left in Raymond van Barneveld?
I think so, yeah, I really think so. But like I said earlier, first you have to get on the way and practice hard and do well in the tour, or have a good run in the UK Open, which is, apart from me in the Premier League, is the only televised event I'm in at the moment. You know, I'm not in the World Match Play, I'm not in the Grand Prix, apart from getting good runs in the Pro or Euro Tour.
Raymond, wish you all the best in your last Premier League campaign. We hope to see you flying the flag for Holland as well. Thank you very much, mate.
Thank you. Thank you.